So I see this is a resistor. No, capacitor, right? Mm-hmm. I don't know. All voltage, okay. Resistor.
And we need that thing.
Okay, so we need the temperature.
Time constant.
Huh?
Time constant.
Time constant, okay. Time constant, okay.
I've been over here for about 30 minutes now.
Really?
Yeah.
Later.
Man, this is so difficult.
Wait, I don't think so.
Got it?
I might. What is it? What's this again?
Time constant.
Oh, I thought it was temperature.
Dang.
Oh.
Why has it got to be so hard with this close to a breakthrough? I wish we had some help.
Me too, man.
Hello, I am the physics guru. Where is my marker, peasant?
Here you go, sir.
Let us do physics. Peasants, the first thing you use. This formula changes to T equals RC.
Oh!
R is for resistance. I should not have written. Fashion guru does not have good handwriting. C is for capacitance. Get ready for your mind to be blown.
Whoa!
I took the resistance, which was the 2.3 times 10 to the 6th power, and then I took the capacitance, which was 3.9 to the negative 6, and then that's going to give me my answer.
That's so easy.
Time constants. So now what we do, we need to find the charge. So we will use this equation. Let's say the time will be 15 seconds. So we're going to use C for our 3.9. So here we go, we're going to write that down. Then we're going to use E, which is going to be 16.2. And then we're going to subtract the 1 minus E to the T time, which we said would be 15 seconds, over the newly found time constant, which would be 8.9 seconds. And then it is complete. All we need to do is solve. Bam! I have made the answer appear magically. And that is how you find the charge.
What the freak? Finally, we finally got the breakthrough we've been looking for.
No.
Thanks, physics guru.
You're welcome. Now, in the name of physics, let's boogie.